Hey, chemistry fans. We noticed some of your questions on our recent videos, so now we're going to take a minute to answer them. Pal Dali asks, how do you become nose blind to certain smells? The reason people can become nose blind is basically the same reason you can tune out a persistent noise and why you literally can't see your nose in front of your face. It's called sensory adaptation. When we're talking about smell, it's specifically referred to as olfactory adaptation. The molecular process in our brain is pretty complex, but basically, we take time into account when we process stimuli. So when an incoming smell is the same for a while, our brain actually starts to downplay that information because it's old news. We only start paying attention if the signal changes, like if it becomes stronger or if someone points it out. But adaptation is totally reversible. You can go nose blind to the smell of your own apartment, but if you come back after a week on the beach in Cancun, those smells will suddenly seem all new again. Hojjat, Abdollahi, and please correct me if I'm not saying these names right, wants to know how come hand sanitizer doesn't dissolve our skin cells? So this is because unlike the single-celled bacteria that get zapped by hand sanitizer, our skin is a complex multi-layered organ that is very, very good at protecting our insides. This includes the tough epidermis layer, which is waterproof and contains a bunch of keratin. That keratin is networked in a tough mesh of filaments, and it's resilient enough that ethanol can't dissolve it from just a quick spritzing. YouTube user The Last Targaryen, nice, asks, can you do a video about mouthwash and whether it's beneficial or not? Research seems to show that mouthwash is a helpful addition to your overall dental routine, because we all have a dental routine. I floss 6 times a day, I don't know about you. Different kinds of mouthwash use all sorts of different active ingredients in an attempt to kill the bacteria that cause stuff like cavities and gum disease. Lab research suggests that some of those active ingredients are more effective than others. Chlorhexidine gluconate is a fairly common one that's effective against a relatively broad range of mouth bacteria, so you shouldn't have too much trouble finding a mouthwash with some research cred to back it up. Thanks for all your awesome questions. To the person who wanted to know what it is in onions that makes you cry, our archive has you covered. And for the person who asked about century eggs, keep your eyes peeled sometime in the next couple of weeks. Got more questions? Drop them in the comments and maybe we'll answer it in another one of these videos, or maybe you can answer somebody else's. Thanks for asking. We'll see you next week.